Morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all my students and my viewers. I am back with another five words for today, and today is Thursday, and we will discuss today weird as well as nice words with the letter D. Word for today is diurnal. Diurnal. D-I-U-R-N-A-L. Diurnal. Now this means daily, or in biology you have studied this means during the day. Something which happens during the day is diurnal, and something which happens during the night is nocturnal. So it can be related to biology as well. Obviously it can be related to that, but in normal English terms, it also means daily. It comes from Latin word dies, D-I-E-S, dies or dies, which means day, and then it translates into diurnus, which means daily, and then later on it then translates into diurnal. So examples we could take: bats and owls are not diurnal creatures. They are not active during the day. They are not diurnal creatures. They are not active throughout the day. They are active at night. So they are not diurnal. Second example, when it comes to daily, the meaning daily, we can take: after having night shifts regularly, he was not able to do his diurnal job, which means daily job. During the day job, he was unable to do his diurnal job during the day. Alright. Okay. So second word for today is dogmatic. D-O-G-M-A-T-I-C. Dogmatic. Now this means making statements which are undeniably true. Okay, undeniably true. Making statements as undeniable. Now this means making statements as undeniably true, which means that whatever you think that's final, and after whatever anybody else says it, you do not agree to it, you do not find it useful. Okay, so it means considering one thing right and everyone else wrong. For example, if you have a dogmatic belief regarding something, you feel that that is the most right thing, and apart from that, everything else is completely wrong. That is being dogmatic. So examples we can take: one cannot be dogmatic in the matter of taste. Obviously, for example, I might like fish more, or you might like chicken more, or nobody, on the other hand, third person might not even like fish, neither chicken. So you cannot be dogmatic regarding your taste, because I cannot say that, okay, fine, I find this tasty, I find this delicious, that's it. Apart from that, everything else is not good, or you cannot call this not tasty. So the sentence which I have made is: one cannot be dogmatic, one cannot be rigid, one cannot be so stern, so stubborn, matlab hum jo bol diye wo bol diye, uske alawa kuch sahi nahi hai. One cannot be that in the matter of taste. Another example we can take: many writers are dogmatic when it comes to their beliefs. Many writers, when they write anything, they are dogmatic. They consider, they believe in something, and they find that to be the truest of all, and apart from that, nothing is true. Apart from that, everything is false. So that is dogmatic. The third word for today is doleful. Doleful. D-O-L-E-F-U-L. Now this is a simple word with simple meaning. It means expressing sorrow. Mournful. Mourn, M-O-U-R-N-F-U-L. Mournful, which means you are sad, you are expressing grief, you are expressing sorrow, you are expressing sadness. Now sentences we can take, it's simple, so you can just say this: her mother had a doleful face when she saw her daughter leaving the house for future studies. When she saw her daughter was leaving the house for future studies, she had a very sad face which was expressing grief, sorrow. Or on seeing, I don't want to take any negative sentences, so I'm not using any death examples, but you can understand that. Second example, we can say she often listens to doleful music. Doleful, very sorrowful music, very sad music. That is her taste. She listens often to that. Doleful, expressing sorrow. All right. The fourth word for today is drastic. Drastic. D-R-A-S-T-I-C. Drastic. Now, this means sudden and severe. Severe, S-E-V-E-R-E, which means extreme. Strong, extremely strong, very strong. That is sudden and something which is extreme, which is severe, which is very strong. That is drastic. Something which happens suddenly with a very long-lasting effect, and that is a very, very, very strong effect. That is drastic. For example, we can say global warming has a drastic effect on the environment today. The global warming, the temperature which is increasing, the carbon dioxide increasing, everything, that has a drastic, it has a very extreme, a very sudden and very severe, a very bad effect on the environment. Second example we can see, she took a drastic step when she decided to leave engineering in between to pursue or to follow her dreams. When she decided to become an actor or decided to become a chef or anything, she left her school, college, engineering career in between, and then she proceeded with her dreams. That is, she took a drastic step, which was sudden and it was severe. Why severe? Because obviously it had a very long-lasting impact on her. It would have. She would have this thing in her mind and wo uske saath bahut din tak rahega. So drastic hai, bahut impactful. Alright, the last word for today is dubious or dubious. British pronunciation is dubious. American pronunciation is dubious. It's dubious. British, dubious. American, dubious. So it comes from a Latin word dubious, D-U-B-I-U-S. It comes from that word, which means doubtful. And then it proceeds to dubiosus and other things, and then it becomes dubious or dubious. It means hesitating, doubtful, person who is not sure with what he's saying or what he's thinking. That is dubious. Examples: one should never depend on a dubious person. Another example we can take, these discoveries are dubious as they are not scientifically proven, which means they are dubious, they are not sure, they are not accurate, they are still in doubt, they are doubtful because they have not been proven scientifically. All right, so today's five words, we completed it. What are those? Let us just see. So first word is diurnal, diurnal, dogmatic. Second word, dogmatic. Third word, doleful, doleful. Fourth word is drastic, drastic. And fifth word is dubious or dubious, dubious or dubious. So these are the five words for the day. Tomorrow is the last day of week 4, and hopefully we will be able to complete with our letter D, and then we'll start with E in the next week. Let's see. So please keep watching, and those who haven't subscribed, you are free to subscribe. I don't like this, like saying this a lot, but then it will be for your benefit. You will just learn a lot of new words. You can do a lot of stuff and put the earphones in your ears, and you can learn a lot of words from this. And whatever feedback you have, the comment section is open. You can just give there. And thank you so much for watching, and stay safe.